right outside the pregame set at Murphy's Bleachers, and we get set to go. Game two, the National League Championship Series, the Los Angeles Dodgers and the Chicago Cubs. Now, welcome inside the broadcast booth, everybody. I'm Joe Buck. The Hall of Famer John Smoltz is coming right up. Well, last night was a thrilling way to start this NLCS. Just the third pinch hit grand slam in postseason history. It came off the bat of Miguel Montero, and in the end, the game was won and lost by the bullpens. Well, that's not the story tonight, at least going in.
Get over here. We're going to talk about Clayton Kershaw. I think it's easy to say that Clayton Kershaw is the best pitcher in the game. I know the LCS numbers aren't good. Some of the postseason success hasn't followed great regular season success, but the Dodgers need him to be the best pitcher in the game tonight.
Absolutely, and only time will tell what the last series had an effect on Clayton Kershaw, but I can guarantee you this, the crowd knows. They're hoping to see a crack. If they're going to beat Clayton Kershaw, he's going to be determined. He's got fastball, curveball, slider. Look, Clayton Kershaw mentally will be drained a little bit more than physically, but look for him to attack this lineup early and be efficient. All he's done on the year has been historic. Those are the numbers that you see a great pitcher put up, and he keeps getting better. He started the season 11-1, you see the K's, and then look at the walks. It seems like a misprint, but then his injury interrupted what was going to be a Cy Young year, and then everybody thought, no way can the Dodgers survive. Not only did they survive, but they put him in a position to have three games in a five-game series. Clayton Kershaw is must-see TV. I can't wait. The crowd secretly can't wait, but they're hoping that their Cubs get on top.
Let's talk about the Cubs side. They've got Kyle Hendricks. Now, he doesn't have the name recognition of John Lester or a Jake Arrieta, but man, has he pitched like a number one starter here at home at Wrigley Field.
Don't be fooled by the lack of miles per hour. His movement is unreal. The sinker, cutter, changeup combination with occasional curveball. He has been dominant at home. He has feasted in this ballpark, used his defense to his advantage, and aside from getting hit in the forearm, the only blemish might be how does he react from that. I think he's going to be excited to get back out there and look for the Dodgers to try and pick out any kind of pitch that's up in the zone. That's really the only chance they have. Swinging down, ground balls.
Well, he started the season as the number five starter in the rotation for the Cubs. He's pitching the second game of the NLCS, and he led the big leagues in ERA for the season. How about a recap of last night's exciting game one from a famous Cubs fan?
Baseball. It's supposed to be fun, full of joy. Well, not for the long-suffering Cub fan. No, we've had it tough. And then last night, you start thinking, is this gonna happen again? And what happens? Miguel Montero.
High drive into right, back at the wall, it is gone!
You heard me, Miguel Montero! Miggy, you know what? This is gonna be our year. pitching tonight for the Dodgers. That's not good. It's not! I love the Cubs. I think we're gonna win, but the word think is there and not know because of Clayton Kershaw.
Clayton Kershaw. So good.
The three-time Cy Young Award winner and MVP in 2014 gets the ball tonight for the Dodgers. Look at this, 69 degrees, cloudy tonight. Hopefully the rain stays away and we go down to the field. Cubs side, talk to Kenny.
Jason Hayward, Joe, is 0 for 10 with 7 strikeouts against Clayton Kershaw, but he's in the Cubs lineup tonight batting 8. Why, you ask? Well, the Cubs don't have a right-handed option with notably better numbers against Kershaw, and also they greatly value Hayward's defense in right field. As we saw last night, their defense can be game-changing. One other note, I spoke with Dodgers president of baseball operations, Andrew Friedman, and he told me the Dodgers clubhouse last night was the most positive he has ever seen after a postseason defeat. The players were confident, full of energy. They could not wait to get started in game 2. Now over to Tom Verducci.
Thanks, Kenny. Well, Clayton Kershaw is pitching for the 4th time in 10 days, so pitch count could be an issue. With that in mind, Dodgers first baseman Adrian Gonzalez said scoring runs early will be paramount to allow him to attack hitters. How many runs? Not many. When the Dodgers score more than 2 runs with Kershaw in the game, he is 102-9. For the Dodgers in game 2, the magic number is 3.
Well said, guys. Thank you. Thanks, Tom. Thanks, Kenny. We'll check on them during the course of the game. And here's the Dodgers lineup. Little different look tonight with Chase Utley digging in. He'll lead it off. Corey Seager bats 2nd tonight. Justin Turner hits 3rd. And it's Gonzalez, Josh Reddick, Jock Peterson, Yasmani Grandal, Andrew Tolles, and Clayton Kershaw pitching and batting 9th. Dave Roberts is nothing if not positive and enthusiastic and kind of a pat you on the back guy. And this is not a dejected Dodger team after losing a heartbreaker last night in game 1. Glad you're with us, and a strike starts tonight for Kyle Hendricks.
Well, for Kyle Hendricks, you're going to see a lot of those if he's on. Highest strike percentage of pitchers, and I think the Dodgers are really trying to make sure that they see the ball up like that and make contact. But he's going to be able to throw in and out and use that changeup. Talking to Adrian Gonzalez, they said the cutter is something that the left-handers are going to have to be on the lookout for.
37-year-old Chase Utley looks at ball 1. The infield plays Utley to pole, to say the least. Chris Bryant is at the normal shortstop position. Left side of the infield is, there's a lot of room over there. 1-2, the count on Utley. Well, you know where they were standing for the Utley at bat. Here are the names on the infield. It's Bryant at 3rd, Addison Russell at short, Javier Baez at 2nd, Anthony Rizzo at 1st. In the outfield, Zobrist, Dexter Fowler, and Jason Hayward is in there, as Kenny said, for the glove. Wilson Contreras, the rookie, does the catching. Hendricks on the mound. Seager, that's the pitch. That is, the arms go up, the pitch tails back, and it's a strike and not a ball.
Yeah, that late movement, it starts out to the hitter as a ball off the plate and ends up to the catcher as a strike.
Only one is missed from Hendricks, and he's 0-2 in a blink on Seager, who has gone 4-for-6 in the first inning, and that's all his damage this postseason. Hitless in all other innings. Ball 1.
With as many left-handers as the Dodgers have in their lineup, I know Russell's penciled in the shortstops on the card, but I don't think he'll be playing shortstop positioning too often tonight on the other side of second base.
Totally full back-to-back strikeouts.
So if you can imagine the shin guards of the catcher
when the pitch starts there, there's the changeup. It looks like it's going to hold its plane, and the ball absolutely darts out of the zone. It's all set up by the fastball, the sinker, and then the hitter cannot recognize because it's coming out of the same slot and the same arm spot. So if you're sitting at home going, how do guys keep swinging these pitches, and how do they keep taking strikes? That's part of the illusion that Kyle Hendricks at 91 miles an hour and under gives the hitters.
Justin Turner now. Strike one. Three batters, three first pitch strikes. Ball one.
He has a unique ability and feel for the baseball to cut it, sink it. He throws two different changeups, a changeup to a right hander that goes and actually cuts, and a changeup that fades from a left hander.
Strike two. He's been 1-2 on each of the first three hitters, and he could strike out the side to start his night. Bottom of the first, game two, all zero. FS1, tonight's telecast is presented by T-Mobile One. How about the numbers for this Cubs lineup against Clayton Kershaw? In that right column, Fowler, as Kevin Burkhardt talked about, with success against him. Not many can claim that across baseball. Bryant, Rizzo, Zobrist, Russell, Baez, Contreras gets the start. Hayward, and then Hendricks. Here's Kershaw. Strike one. Eric Cooper, the home plate umpire, seems a little more generous with the strike zone tonight, which should make for a little better pace to this game, too. That skips in. One ball, one strike.
Yeah, I'm so intrigued with the game plan that's going to be employed by the Cubs. And the first inning should tell a lot. If they come out and they're aggressive against first pitch fastballs and then adjust later or vice versa, make him work, see what kind of stuff he has. Kershaw has, and you saw right there, that slider. It's very firm, and that is the pitch that's taken him to the next level.
Postseason starts have ended in heartbreak more times than not for Clayton Kershaw in his incredible career. Try to get through some of the numbers and also let you enjoy the game. Here in this first inning, he steps off 126 and 60 in his regular season big league career with a career ERA of 2.37 for Clayton Kershaw. That's chopped to third. Tough play, Turner. God, what a play by the Dodger third baseman, and a good start behind Clayton Kershaw.
Yeah, the only way I think he makes that play is he's already starting in against Fowler. Not for sure that he won't lay down a bunt, but his depth in was the only reason he could get Fowler on this play. A good start
into this postseason. As you look one more time at where Turner started, Clayton Kershaw with a career postseason record of 2-6 and an ERA over 4.5, which is just hard to understand. There's a good pitch over the inside part to Chris Bryant, strike one.
Yeah, well, if he gets that pitch right there, you can pretty much chalk up a lot of zeros. That pitch in is going to have such an effect on Cubs hitters. That pitch might have been a little off the plate, so right now lenient on the inside part of the plate for strikes.
And now to the outside part, Kershaw hits his spot, 0-2.
His fastball does not have a lot of movement. It's pretty straight, but it's firm. 95 to 96 miles an hour. You'll see this big breaking slow curveball, the hard cutter, and an occasional changeup.
That's down, ball one. So the third postseason start this postseason for Kershaw. Add into that a 7-pitch save in game 5. Division series against the Nationals. He's been busy. 1-2. Bryant able to lay off. 2-2. And there's all the action for Clayton Kershaw. And yes, he's on regular rest from that game 4 start, which happened on Tuesday, but he had to ramp it up for the game 5 save on Thursday. Outside corner struck him out. 2-0.
Both sides of the plate, command and touch early on, very good. And if this is going to be the case, that's where I think the Cubs are going to have to be more aggressive. With two strikes, Kershaw is nasty anyways, but with two strikes, he's virtually almost impossible to get hits against. Unique mechanics, kind of a double leg kick. Fun to watch.
Anthony Rizzo hasn't had much fun this postseason. 1-for-20 without an RBI. Pops it up, out of play. Such a big reason why the Cubs are here, that back-to-back of Bryant and Rizzo. Drove home 109 runs during the regular season. Hit 32 home runs in 292, but just one single. And he's gone through some dry spells, as you can see with that bottom line on the graphic. Cubs looking for him to bust out. Got under it. Out behind second base, and Peterson will come in. A 1-2-3 inning on each side. And a good start here in game 2. Peterson glad he caught it. No score. Field in Chicago. The pictures just could not be any prettier. Lincoln Motor Company keys to the game. John Smoltz.
Well, get a lead. That seems elementary, but we already heard from Tom and what that lead does for the greatest pitcher in the game. And then make Kershaw work. The Cubs got their hands worked in for him, and I think the strike zone is going to determine a little bit of that. As we saw early on, Eric Cooper has given both sides of the plate to two pitchers who rely on both sides of the plate. Hitters beware.
Here is Gonzalez, who reached Aroldis Chapman for a two out two run single into center in last night's eighth inning. Huge swing of the bat against a fastball that was pumped in there at over 100 miles per hour. He can go on tears where he is an RBI machine. This one hit in the air to left center field. It is gone. Dodgers lead. It's Adrian Gonzalez going deep. 1-0 LA. It was Gonzalez who told us outside their clubhouse before tonight's game, with Kershaw on the mound, get him a couple early and let him settle in.
Now, first of all, he's got one of the prettiest swings in baseball, and his game plan second to none. He knows, based on the video and the information, what to look for. You can't cover everything against a guy like Hendricks. And he said he will be looking in with the cutters, trying to look in one area and then away. And basically did exactly that. Took the pitch away, didn't try to do too much.
One ball, one strike on Josh Reddick. Adrian Gonzalez is a guy who was a 40 home run a year hitter for the San Diego Padres in that huge ballpark. It's since been made smaller. Here's Hendricks with a nice play. One out. This year, Gonzalez hit 18 home runs, but shows power the opposite way.
Yeah, no wasted movement, and he goes with it, right? If you try to pull that ball, his results are going to be much different. This guy has all the makings of frustrating a pitcher when he's locked in. By the way, if that ever happened to me right there, surgery on the left shoulder, gone. It might have fallen off.
One out, nobody on, a run home. Here's Jock Peterson. Strike one. Jock has been hot since the 1st of September, hitting 293 and a home run basically every 10 at bats. Prior to that, was hitting just 239, and the home run rate was down. He pulled back from a strike, and it's 0-2. He didn't like the call.
No, he asked if that was in the bottom of the zone. Because they have the shift on, all that Jock Peterson has to do is square around and sacrifice. He knows it's a hit. And I think his first initial response was that ball was down.
Now the 0-2 from Hendricks. In the air to left field. Back is Zobrist. Two out. We told you Eric Cooper is the home plate umpire. The crew chief is Gary Cederstrom. He's at first base. He'll work game three behind the plate in L.A. on Tuesday. That's Angel Hernandez at second. Alfonso Marquez at third. Ted Barrett down the left field line. And Paul Nauert, who worked the plate last night, he's in right. Replay official is Bill Welke. Back in New York, and he'll join the on-field crew when this series changes to the West Coast. Here's Grandal, ball one. Osmani last night came into the ballgame, ended up 0-for-2.
Well, remember I said you got to make the ball get up if possible. Take care of the mistakes. This is a mistake. Change up, and enough movement kept it off the barrel of the bat, or that ball's a home run. The previous pitch, down. Those are where the outs are for Kyle Hendricks.
Count's gone to 3-0 on Grandal, who's 3-for-28 in his short postseason career. Dodgers eliminated by the Mets last year, who were the National League champs. That's a strike. Huh. Here's a 3-1.
'89 seemed like '95. Looking for movement. What do you get? The cutter here, the changeup.
Fastball away for ball four. Hendricks walked just 44 during the regular season. Coverage of this game in Spanish. Please tune to Fox Deportes. Two out walk, and here is Andrew Tolles, who came on last night and delivered not just in the pinch, but also had an RBI double. What was a one run ninth inning, so he was 2 for 2. Great speed, and he showed that last night. Ball one inside. Ken Rosenthal has more on Andrew Tolles, whether we can get to that here or not. Kind of up to Kendricks and Tolles. Kenny, this is an interesting story, Andrew Tolles.
He sure is. He was out of baseball last year. The Dodgers signed him to a minor league deal in September. Before that, he had been working as a grocery clerk part-time at a Kroger's outside Atlanta. Well, story ended up pretty well for him. He rose, shot through the Dodgers farm system. Gabe Kapler, the farm director, was his biggest advocate. Knew him from Tampa Bay. Here he is tonight.
That's over toward Kenny. And the inning. But in the frame, it's Adrian Gonzalez who has put the Dodgers on top. He takes Hendricks deep. LA on top for Kershaw, 1-0. Four, five, and six hitters for the Cubs down 1-0 after the home run by Adrian Gonzalez. Zobrist into center. Peterson, a late break, but he's there. One out. Only 12 pitches to get four outs so far for Clayton Kershaw.
I still think that's the right approach for the Cubs. Kershaw is so good that you're caught on expecting a guy to get a little wild. We saw that two walks in the first 12 games or something. He is just so good with his fastball, so you have to make a decision, the one that you like early, to try to attack.
He walked only 11 all year in 149 innings pitched. Strike one is right down the chute to Addison Russell, who's 1-for-19 this postseason. And this is a guy who drove in 95 runs. So that combo of Rizzo and Russell coming into this game, 2-for-39 with two singles so far this postseason, and yet here are the Cubs up 1-0 in the NLCS. Doing it with their pitching and defense. Some timely hits. Good pitch. Strike two.
Well, you think about it. Glass half full or glass half empty for the Cubs. They've won these games despite those numbers. But then you wonder if those numbers continue. Can they continue to keep winning? They have to have some of these guys get out of the funk. And the middle part of this lineup, 4, 5, 6, and even 3 with Rizzo.
Left side from the hole. Seager showing what he can do. What a play. And he gets Addison Russell, who can run. That is a good play by a big bodied shortstop.
Makes it look real easy. To be this big and to have the kind of feet that he has and athletic ability. Whether he stays there or not, this is a big young man, by the way. Kind of like seeing a Labrador in the paws and wondering how big he's going to get. Shaking his hand, you get that same feeling.
He's 6'4", 215, and he looks bigger than that when you're standing next to him. But as far as height, 6'4". And he's only 22 years old. Strike one is into Javier Baez, who this October has become a fan favorite here at Wrigley. One ball, one strike. So far, good zip with the stuff for Clayton Kershaw. Stole home last night. Just the sixth to do it in LCS history. LCS starting in 1969. Divisional play. 1-2 on Baez.
To really perfect a changeup. For the most part, he broke into this league with fastball. Everything was hard, fastball, and then the curveball was his change of speeds. Now he's got the hard slider, obviously the firm fastball. That curveball is really an effective pitch for keeping the hitters off balance, because even though he's trying to get that changeup, that's what happens.
Baez chased it, a 96 mile per hour fastball, and Kershaw, two innings. No base runners. Third inning rolls in at Wrigley. Dodgers batting up one.
Tonight's aerial coverage brought to you by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you got to get DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. Clayton Kershaw leads it off, and he is the student of the guy we're about to talk to, longtime pitching coach for the Dodgers, Rick Honeycutt. Hello, Honey.
Hello, Joe.
What do you see so far from Clayton Kershaw?
Very efficient, fastball to both sides. Obviously, the slider mixed in the curveball, so even mixed in the Rich Hill drop down there on the last pitch. So a little uniqueness so far.
2-0 the count on Kershaw, who can swing the bat. He grounds to Rizzo for out number one. Without revealing too much, Rick, what conversation did you have with Clayton before tonight's start, with all the work he's had in that last series coming into this start with regard to pitch count or whatever you might want to throw out there?
Yeah, you know, the main thing after the game they came in to save the game in Washington was just making sure how his body felt, and each day, you know, checking with him, because it's really something a little bit different. I mean, he's done it a few times in the past, but you know, nothing in recent years where he's, you know, pitched out of the pen and done that.
Rick, you've seen him forever. How is he on game days, and can you tell when something is amped up a little bit more? Is he a guy that his own program, don't talk to him, let us do his thing, or how does he approach a game, especially at this time of the year?
No, he's very open, very studious on preparation of how he's going to go about it, and he likes it two hours in advance. So he's very meticulous in his time usage on the day that he pitches, and has his routine. And we sit down with him, with the catcher, and we go through and talk about the hitters a little bit. And then after that, it's really he just puts the game face on and going through his routine.
You would like Clayton Kershaw to be the setup man tonight for Kenley Jansen, wouldn't you?
Well, that would be a good scenario for us. Yes.
Rick, thanks for the time.
All right, guys.
All right. Rick Honeycutt, a terrific pitcher in his own right, now a really well respected pitching coach with the Dodgers. That's down and away. The count's gone to 3-1 on Chase Utley.
Yeah, so far, Dodgers approach the last two games as an offense has been really good. And they didn't get rewarded yesterday for their approach off of John Lester. So far, they've been able to stay away from swinging too far off the zone.
That drills the inside part. The count's full on Utley. Six-time All-Star and a real leader at the age of 37. He has seen and done it all. He has an incredible work ethic, a good influence on that young shortstop who bats behind him tonight. Full count. Out of play.
When you get into a game like this, you're having to read the hitters after your scouting report. What I mean by that is, who's jumpy, who's anxious, who's trying to get out and get something. And so far, the read has been not too anxious. The first inning was really good for Hendricks, but since then he's been up and hasn't pounded the ball in the areas that he's intended to target wise as much.
So the count will stay full after back to back foul balls off the bat of Chase Utley. Tonight's telecast is sponsored by T-Mobile One. Welcome to Unlimited Baseball. And by the Lincoln Motor Company. Third inning, 1-0 Dodgers on the home run by Adrian Gonzalez. One out, nobody on. And a 3-2 pitch. Got it, Loken. Strikeout number 3.
Well, Chase Morton likely wasn't going to do anything with this pitch anyways, and he was hoping it was going to be a ball. It might have been. Mr. Cooper didn't think so. Chase was caught looking as he was running the first, thinking ball 4.
Here's Seager. Ball 1. Corey Seager hit 308 during the regular season. As we talked about last night, he came up at the end of last year, was a part of the postseason in 2015. And there's just no telling how good his big league career will get. And there have been a lot of overtures over the past couple of years by other teams as the Dodgers have looked to add the trading deadline, dying to get their hands on Corey Seager. The Dodgers just never would pull the trigger on that deal. And now that you see Seager, you understand why.
Yeah, he's their best hitter. How many times can you say that about a young guy that comes up and instantaneously is in the middle of the batting order right when he gets called up?
3-1 as it was on Utley.
All change up so far. Only the 2-0 pitch did he swing and miss.
That's that same pitch that struck out Utley and the count's full. Two out walk. Second walk handed out by Kyle Hendricks. Experience every postseason moment with MLB.com at bat, the number one app for live baseball. It's the only place to get it all. Live radio feeds, video highlights, pitch tracking, stat cast, and much more. Download at bat today. Here's Justin Turner. Last night went 1-for-4. He's 1-for-5 in this series and 7-for-20 this postseason.
Not much on the first pitch. Pretty patient. Doesn't have the high average you see everybody have on first pitch aggressive swings.
With two out, ball one. Hendricks started out 3-for-3. First three batters, first pitch strikes, 5-for-12 now. And he has fallen behind even Kershaw in this inning. So Hendricks is a little off.
Yeah, and that's what I saw after the first inning. He was really sharp. You come out with the adrenaline. You're trying to figure out your game plan, executing your game plan, then adjusting to what the hitters are or are not doing. And so far, the Dodgers have been very disciplined.
It's game three after a travel day tomorrow and a pitching matchup. Jake Arrieta, the reigning Cy Young Award winner, against Rich Hill. In-season pickup from the A's. 2-0 pitch. In at the knees. Joe Maddon said when he studies Kyle Hendricks, he's learned that when Hendricks drops his head, it doesn't mean he's defeated. It means he's mad, disappointed, but not defeated. And there's a big difference between those two. He's a thinker, went to Dartmouth. Smart young man, 26 years old. Born in Newport Beach, California.
Yeah, his pulse of personality is going to beat to a different drum. He just doesn't have a lot of emotion, so sometimes you can have a false read, and that's what Joe Maddon was talking about. He is business as usual, no big thing, no high heartbeat, no low one, just kind of right in the middle. He's trying to execute with that fine, I would call, accuracy on both sides of the plate.
Again, falling behind in the count, 3-1. He came back to strike out Utley. He could not come back to get Seager. And now a dangerous pitch coming to a good hitter, Justin Turner. Hit 27 home runs during the regular season.
You know what I love about this situation? In a regular season game, a 3-1 pitch, one out, runner on first is no big deal. This is a huge deal in the postseason. It matters so much more. The crowd's into it, and you realize the magnitude of the game.
That's outside. Back-to-back walks. And Adrian Gonzalez will have an opportunity here with two out in the third inning to add to the lead. This is a little bit, John, what Joe Maddon referenced with regard to the start that Hendricks made in the division series. Trying to be too fine, trying to be too perfect, make that perfect pitch, and now he's falling behind hitters, and that's going to bring about a visit from Chris Bosio.
Well, and it all goes to the theme of what a pitcher has to do before he plays in a game like this. You're in a regular season game, nobody interviews you the day before. You don't do press conferences. You're not talking and thinking about a game 4 days in advance. and of course watching his teammate Lester, I don't know how much you learned from him being on the mound. So you prepare for that game, not guaranteed another one. And that's why only the pitcher and the player knows what kind of motor goes on in the inside in these moments. I can tell you this, though, with two outs during the regular season, this guy was about as stingy as it comes with runners in scoring position. And he's hoping to live up to that as well in this situation.
Well, it's two on, two out for Adrian Gonzalez, the vet, right in the heart of this Dodger lineup. He's already homered tonight. Strike one.
One thing you can't do as a pitcher is get fearful of a pitch down and away that he took for a home run. If you want to open that back up, you're going to have to throw a cutter in at some point to Adrian Gonzalez.
Fooled him. Strike two.
He throws a changeup in the area where the sinker was deposited for a home run.
Gonzalez is a studier, somebody who really thinks about approach and at bats before a game, puts together a game plan, and has the ability with his good hands to execute it. Oh, that hit, thankfully, the back wall next to Joe Maddon, and no person, especially that kid.
So everything has been away, and Adrian's been on it and covering and following off those pitches. So something about what they're trying to do is getting Adrian to look out over the plate.
Looking for their first base runner as Gonzalez strands a pair in the third. 1-0 Dodgers on the home run by Adrian Gonzalez in the second. Clayton Kershaw has been sharp. It's Contreras, Hayward, and Hendricks. Wilson Contreras is only 24 years old, but it took him a while to get his pro career started. And when it started, everything clicked. He's just taking off. I think he's taking this pitch. Ball one that missed, and Contreras went up there taking that first one. He's been good this postseason, 4 out of 6. Had that huge hit in game 4 in San Francisco. He's taken a strike. 1-1.
Well, he's been pretty fearless since he's gotten called up. Could play another position like many of these Cubs players.
Good pitch from Kershaw, strike 2.
I just think, look, what makes the Cubs successful? They let all the baseball in walks. They work counts, they get on base, they utilize the long ball. Guess what? This guy doesn't walk anybody. Abandon that philosophy.
Right down the chute at 94, strikeout number 3.
I don't see too many wasted at bats in the postseason because nobody takes at bats off. That was a wasted at bat. That at bat did absolutely nothing on what he was trying to do. First and foremost, taking those 2 pitches and then taking strike 3 right down the middle. So interesting game plan. Maybe he's got a game plan that he will showcase later.
1 out, nobody on. Here's Hayward, who does not have a hit in his career against Kershaw, 0-for-10. Two for 15 postseason after a disappointing regular year, hitting just .230. Broken bat, easy for Turner, plenty of time. First 8 retired in order with the pitcher Kyle Hendricks coming up. This postseason continues tomorrow, the ALCS in Canada. They'll be in Toronto. The Indians and the Blue Jays on TBS. Followed by game 4 on Tuesday. Then later that night, it's game 3 of the NLCS as the Cubs take on the Dodgers. Arrieta takes on Rich Hill. In LA, 7:30 Eastern, only on FS1 or watch it live on Fox Sports Go. Here's Hendricks, who had a 2-run single in the game 2 start against the Giants. He got a no decision, was hit in the forearm, in his right arm. Line drive by Angel Pagan in the 4th inning, had to come out. He had 2 of the 6 RBIs that the Cubs pitchers racked up against the Giants. Kershaw looks terrific. Big curveball missing, ball 1.
Yeah, you just got to find a way to create stress. This will be a long game for Kershaw. And what I mean by that, mentally, after what he went through in this previous postseason series, I'll expand on that a little bit later. Stay tuned.
Leave the audience wanting more and hanging. 1-0 Dodgers after 3. only swing that's mattered so far. Adrian Gonzalez with that home run in the second, ball one missing, down and away to Josh Reddick. Fourth inning, 1-0 Dodgers. Reddick, Peterson, and Grandal against Kyle Hendricks, the 26-year-old, 6'3", 190. One ball, one strike.
When they got Reddick, he really struggled coming over. For the Dodgers, since he's been with them, left-handers, he has really hit nothing. But right-handers, a 295 average, and that's what he's in for, is the right-handers in these series.
So it's Reddick and Wright tonight. Season pickup. Puig on the bench. Puig 0 for 9 this postseason, 1 for his last 25 during the postseason. Here's a 2-1. Fooled him out in front of an 81 mile an hour pitch, 2-2.
Now, the oddity about some of his changeups, because I just got done telling you most of his strikeouts are down, he will try to throw some changeups up because it gives the illusion that that pitch is a fastball.
2-2.
And there's amazing similarities. I know it's not going to be absolutely one for one when I make this comparison, but he does remind me of my teammate Greg Maddux. And Maddux, in this ballpark, learned how to go from a four-seam fastball to a sinker, cutter. He had the same kind of stuff, but turned it into a Hall of Fame career. And I'm not by any stretch of the imagination trying to say Hendricks is on that same path.
May have broken his back. Zobrist one out.
But their approach and the way they read hitters is similar. He has a sinker that moves, creates movement and an illusion, and then he'll follow that up with the ability to throw changeups, okay, and then he'll cut the ball as well. But that changeup off the sinker reminds me of Greg Maddux. The best changeup for a right-hander I've ever seen. The movement was unbelievable, and it just seemed like even if it was 3-2 and they knew it was coming, there's nothing they could do. That's the similarity. They both kind of pitch with a quiet head. Greg Maddux, the best mechanically I've ever seen, with that quiet head towards home plate. And of course, the ability to spot the ball wherever he wanted to. And so I can give you an illustration at home. When you see a sinker that moves and a cutter that doesn't, the hitter's anticipating it's going to move. That cutter actually breaks more bats.
Into left field, easy for Zobrist. There was a guy who went pretty good through one postseason after another, named Mariano Rivera, who threw a cutter that broke bat after bat after bat.
It's an amazing phenomenon, because it was almost like, the best way I can describe it, is like throwing a football. The spin that he had, and it was so late that the hitter would go to attack the ball, and of course the ball, late movement, would create a lot of wood that was not being able to be used anymore.
Big swing by Grandal.
But I would watch Greg Maddux throw a cutter, and I'd go, man, if you watched it for face value, you'd go, that's not really a real good pitch. But it served an incredible purpose, because the anticipation of seeing a ball move away, the hitter goes to hit it and it misses the barrel.
Ball and a strike on Grandal. Walked his first time up. 2-1. Number 7 hitter. Top 27 home runs this season. Switch hitting catcher takes a strike, 2-2. Top of the order for Chicago in the bottom of the inning. Hendricks trying to keep it a one-run game. Just caught it. Due up third. Fowler, Bryant, Rizzo. Coming up, 1-0 Dodgers. Houston Astro. Current Chicago Cub Dexter Fowler leads it off. Takes a ball. Fowler just wanted to be a part of this. After his contract expired last year, he signed late, surprised his teammates in spring training, and boy, did they need him. Switch hitting leadoff man for this Cubs lineup. Some power, stole 13 bases, plays the heck out of center. Good pickup with a backhand by Turner, and the Cubs still don't have a base runner through 3 1/3.
Well, we showed you Hendricks, but here's the difference with Kershaw. Powerful lower body. Here's what typically happens. You keep going, right? No. He picks his leg back up for a secondary kind of leg kick, and that little hesitation has always been, from his junior year on, kind of his mechanics. And all that Clayton Kershaw does is perfect it. And he does it better than anybody else. That's why his location is impeccable and his stuff is hard to hit.
Bryant takes a ball low, 95 from the lefty.
Because he doesn't throw a lot of pitches with his fastball that move, he has to be good with his location. So mechanically, he has to be better than most.
Kershaw, who's got a Gold Glove award on his resume, takes care of Bryant, two out.
And the other thing that makes it so tough, Joe, is because that fastball has velocity, it's the slider. The slider, you cannot recognize it because the spin on his slider is so tight and it has so many revolutions that the hitter, when you see a fastball four seam, it will sometimes give you the appearance that it rises. But a slider, if tight, is a red dot. If it's not tight, it has a big circle. That's when the hitter's eyes light up. Not too many big circles, by the way, when he throws his slider.
Here's Rizzo now. You're talking about a red dot because of the red stitching on a baseball. And that's actually a pitch that Clayton Kershaw really started to throw in games when the Dodgers were here at Wrigley Field with his very good friend and a longtime big league bullpen catcher. And coach, here's one down the right field line. But foul off the bat of Rizzo. One ball, one strike, and Cub fans hoping that's a sign of life for their big first baseman.
Yeah, what little wind is blowing was trying to keep that ball fair. It's blowing left, right to left. You see it hooking, and then it kind of straightens out. But not enough to make a difference.
Whoa. 2-1.
That's how you keep somebody from getting and covering the outer third of the plate. Clayton trying to go in, goes up and in. You see his hands over the plate, and he's able to get out of the way of that pitch. At some point he will be throwing a curveball to Rizzo. Curveballs from left-handers give him some fits.
Strike two, just to finish on the slider. Longtime big league bullpen catcher and coach Mike Borzello was in on the conversation late May in 2009 when Kershaw kind of talked into using that slider. There's Borzy. What a pitch that's become. 2-2. Right side. Easy for Gonzalez. Kershaw covers. Clayton Kershaw is perfect through four. Fifth inning rolls in at Wrigley Field. Dodgers batting up one. It's on FS1. Tonight's telecast is presented by T-Mobile One. T-Mobile One lets MLB fans dig into the game with unlimited LTE data on their smartphones. Show us how you're baseball's number one fan using hashtag unlimited baseball for a free MLB shop gift code and a chance to win tickets to every 2017 World Series game. Kershaw has shut down the Dodgers, or rather the Cubs, and for the Dodgers, they've squeaked out one run. We've seen a lot of that. Dodger hitters out in front of that good change from Kyle Hendricks. This is Andrew Toles, strike one. Toles and Kershaw, then Utley. And action starts for the Cubs in their bullpen.
I think for Joe Maddon, he's trying his best to treat this game as if getting one or two runs off of Kershaw is going to be very difficult. So if he sees any issues moving forward to keep the game at one run, he is going to do that.
It's Mike Montgomery who's getting loose, a left-hander in the pen for Chicago. Mike pitched in last night's game, went one third of an inning, allowed a run. 1-2 pitch. Now a 2-2. Got him swinging, strikeout number 5. One out.
Well, Toles definitely has shown he can handle the fastball. The off speed has been tough. There's the changeup grip, there's the late movement, tremendous arm action. Just can't tell as a hitter when it's coming out of the same slot and the arm is coming through the same arm speed as the velocity as a fastball. Difficult to tell the two apart. And I got to say this, for Kyle Hendricks, I think baseball as a whole is missing out on potential Kyle Hendricks in the future. What I mean by that, we're so enamored with velocity and all the power arms that are in the game. This guy is a pitcher. He has learned how to become a pitcher. He will eat up innings. And I think the guys that are being missed in the draft because they don't light up the radar gun is hurting baseball, in my opinion, in the long run.
Well, that's all that organizations are looking for, innings eaters. Hard to find. Hendricks looks like he's a nice find. There's Kershaw with a base hit into left center field. He's trying to do everything tonight. On with one out here in the fifth. The second hit of this postseason.
Kershaw, such a good athlete. And he's actually hit a home run and won 1-0. A pitcher's dream, by the way. Hit it out, shut him out.
Did that a few years back. He only has that one big league home run. He can handle the bat. Talking it over with Anthony Rizzo at first. Here's Utley. In case the Dodgers want to get any action going on the bases, although with Kershaw, maybe not. Throw over nonetheless.
They've done a great job staying away from Chase Utley.
That's a strike. Hendricks may be pitching to stay in the game right here with the left-handed hitting Corey Seager on deck and the left-hander Montgomery about ready in the bullpen.
Well, this ball shows the tremendous movement that he has. You see Utley jumping out of the way, what he thinks is a ball, ended up right down the middle. Utley still has that nitro zone down and in, short, compact stroke.
This is going to be a tough play. Hendricks made it. Two out. And now a decision coming for Joe Maddon.
A little excuse me swing. And a really good athletic play by Hendricks. If
he doesn't make that play, to your point, Joe, that might have been the time he, Joe Maddon, goes out and gets the left-hander.
He still may. And I think you're dead on. It's the pitching of Clayton Kershaw that, if there is a pitching change, would be the reason behind it, because you just can't fall any further behind. That's how good Kershaw looks tonight. And he's done with a bat what the Cubs have not been able to do against him with a bat.
Now can Kyle Seager sit? Corey, sorry, I knew that. I knew that was coming. Corey Seager sit on an off-speed pitch, because he has just got a whole array of changeups. Easier said than done for a hitter. But that's the game plan so far from Hendricks.
Big run sitting out there, and it's Kershaw on the bases at second with two out. The 0-1.
Rizzo. I got it.
That'll do it. That's five strong innings from Kyle Hendricks. But Kershaw's been a little bit better. Back to work he goes. 1-0 LA. Perfect innings from Kershaw, up 1-0.
Well, here's what makes him so tough. You gotta look at this fastball, which is great in and of itself. And then off of the fastball comes this slider. And what makes it so difficult is the spin on the slider. You see at 2579, that's way above the average of spin rates for slider. 2287 is the major league average. And what Clayton Kershaw does is spin it and throw it very firm.
We introduce PitchCast, powered by MLB Advanced Media. Spin rate, double leg kick, whatever it is, it's working for Clayton Kershaw tonight. Strike one to Ben Zobrist. One ball.
ball, one strike. More on the slider. Here's Tom Verducci.
Well, as you mentioned, Joe, it was right here at Wrigley Field 7 years ago when Clayton Kershaw discovered that slider. He had trouble getting calls and swings on that big curveball. You mentioned the bullpen catcher for the Dodgers.
Here's one in the left. Back at the track. One out.
It was Mike Borzello, the Dodgers bullpen catcher at the time. Well, 12 years before that, in a bullpen in Detroit, Mariano Rivera first threw his cutter. His bullpen catcher was Mike Borzello with the New York Yankees. Guys, that's like being in the lab with Edison and Crick and Watson, two of the best pitchers of this generation, and Mike Borzello was right there in the lab at their discoveries.
It's the Borzello effect. It's well known across Major League Baseball. Making his dad Matt happy, and a longtime coach for Joe Torre. He's got rings because of those years with the Yankees, went with Torre to LA, and now he is on his second administration here with the Cubs.
I wonder what it would have been like.
Here's one into left center field. Back is Jock Peterson.
If Borzello went to Kershaw before his start the other day and said, hey, look, I got the secret. I've told our guys the secret. Better not throw the slider tonight. I don't think that's kind of how it went. And for Clayton Kershaw, he's gone to that next level, as you talked about, with that slider. And honestly, this season, really working hard to get that fourth pitch. He is not content with the numbers that he's put up. He still thinks he can get better. Scary thought.
Now with two out, nobody on, here's Baez. Still no base runners for the Cubs. Baez was trying to become a base trotter with that swing. Big cut. Fouled it back, strike one.
Staying in on him has been a theme that most teams have tried to get him from hitting the ball out.
There's the first base runner of the night. Comes with two out in the fifth. And why wouldn't it be Javier Baez?
Well, he's been in better balance, and the only time that that pitch is really going to have an effect if he's out of balance and jumping to the ball. And even the fastball swing, even though it's a big swing, he's much more in balance right here, taking it up the middle. See how the foot gets down, and then even though he's fooled, his hands are back enough to get enough on that swing. Speaks to his strength, speaks to the maturity of this young man in a little over 2 years.
And the great hands which he's displayed defensively, showing their swing in the bat. Now Contreras came up in mid-June, ended up hitting 12 home runs.
I would throw a slider first pitch right here. Went with the heater. I think anytime a guy goes up there, at least for me, when he just puts the bat on his shoulders and takes, it makes him aggressive the second at bat. And so if you think he's swinging, you either make a great pitch in, like Clayton did with the fastball, or spin something.
That's what Contreras did his first time, was up there to take a strike and eventually took a third strike. Kershaw struck out four, walked nobody, allowed one hit, leads by one.
One thing you're definitely not going to do against Kershaw is take a base. He just does not give up stolen bases. Only one on the year.
Contreras has got some pop. And that throw to first. We're talking to Adrian Gonzalez about the pickoff throw. That was just a lollipop throw over to first base, but it's that slide step. You typically see a pitcher used to the plate with a guy on. He uses it as he throws to first.
Well, very close of that 45 degree angle of which he is allowed to step as a left hander.
That's up the middle, base hit. And even though Baez is running around, it's two on, two out. Javier Baez tried to draw an errant throw, and it almost worked by rounding second hard.
He's just like a young puppy. Got to get that energy out of him. That was all meant to be right there.
It was just someone having fun.
Well, here's Hayward. He's tired of people like me talking about how disappointing 2016 has been. He's in this lineup tonight. Joe Maddon called it his toughest decision, putting a starting lineup together for this game. In there for his defense, looking for a two out hit. And takes a fastball for strike one.
Well, Solera's on deck because he'll pinch hit for the pitcher. Some would think maybe pinch hit Solera here with two outs. Like I said, the start of this postseason, if you want somebody to forget about your regular season, a big hit in the postseason is all it will do.
0-1. He was jammed, popped up. Turner is there, and Kershaw gives up his first hit. Hayward, a quiet out to end the fifth. Still 1-0. Dodgers on top. Wrigley Field on the north side of Chicago. Great setting for baseball, great setting for anything. Wrigleyville, one hopper. Russell off the bat of Turner, one out. And we'll see if Joe Maddon stays with Hendricks with a couple of lefties coming up. He's got Travis Wood, left-handed pitcher, ready to go. That was a quick out, and he may stick with his starter against Gonzalez, who homered his first time up.
Hendricks has done a great job because after the first inning, there were some signs again of being a little rusty, not pinpoint control, leaving some balls in the area where it gave the Dodgers an opportunity to do some damage.
Gonzalez, ball one.
Coming into this game, Joe, I thought we had a chance to see at any point in this series the most combined innings out of any two starters because, let's face it, the Dodgers just don't go deep with their starting rotation. So Kershaw and Hendricks could provide the most innings from any starters, and they haven't disappointed here in the sixth. 1-0.
Chris Bosio going to give the instructions to the guys down in the bullpen as to what to look for the next couple of hitters. Good changeup. And that's really what's discussed. It was discussed last night with Aroldis Chapman by Joe Maddon. He said, you have Seager. He didn't know when Seager came up it was going to be bases loaded, nobody out. Those guys know when they're getting loose who Joe Maddon has in mind for them as they prepare. Base is empty, 1-1. 2-1.
This postseason started for the Cubs in a gem by Cueto and Lester. Zeros for almost the entire game to the eighth. Lester didn't disappoint. He wasn't as sharp yesterday, but only gave up one run, and that was a wind-blown home run.
2-1. 3-1.
Pretty sure Hendricks knew coming into this game. You don't pitch against the other pitcher, but subconsciously you know you can't give up two. You can't give up three. And right now, he's trying to keep it right here at one.
You know what Gonzalez is thinking? He's already homered once. And now he takes a walk. We'll see if that's it. Walk number four for Kyle Hendricks. And here comes Reddick. There's a difference in the game. Statcast powered by Amazon Web Services.
Yeah, great swing on a sinker. You see just enough, 384. The gap here at 368 is what makes the friendly confines such a hitter's dream when the wind's not blowing in.
Well, even with two guys up after the walk, Maddon sticks with Hendricks and he finds a strike to Reddick. The night for Josh. He's grounded out, fly to left. 4 for 17 this postseason. He's got some pop in that bat. Good start to this season in Oakland. That's the opposite way and a base hit for Reddick. And now it's two on with only one out and the Dodgers are in business in the sixth. That quick out that Hendricks got on the first pitch to Justin Turner I think bought him one more batter. Then the walk followed. Then you're looking down into the bullpen, into the dugout. No pitching change. Well, after that hit by Reddick, that's going to be it for the 26-year-old Hendricks. And it's the right-hander. Carl Edwards coming on with Jock Peterson coming up. Nice hand for Hendricks.
happened last night.
Struck out a hitter, walked a hitter, is the call out of the bullpen, the AT&T call to the bullpen. With the left-handed hitting Jock Peterson coming up, and I can only assume this is a hunch or a feel by Joe Maddon to leave the left-hander out of the bullpen.
I think he's going with velocity, and a four-seam velocity beats the barrel of the bat to Peterson. That's the only thing I can think of. Sinkers much better for Peterson off of right-handers. Four-seamers, even though 11 home runs. He goes with the curveball. I think what I'm only guessing here, that Joe Maddon likes the velocity four-seam fastball combination with the curveball against Peterson rather than bringing in Wood to face Peterson and Grandel.
Nothing in one, the count, two on with one out. Dodgers trying to add to their lead and get out of Chicago with a series tied at one. Broken bat. That is a short hop. And they have the other runner hung up. What a smart play by Baez. Inning is over. Baez let the ball bounce and turned it into a double play. That was brilliant. He's doing everything right as he has walked to the center of the stage here in October. He could have caught it on a fly, played it on the short hop, got the force at second, and then Gonzalez was caught as Addison Russell was told to throw to third by Baez. What a play. Still 1-0. So good. And now the mind was good. John, he knew exactly what he wanted to do when that ball was hit.
He did, and Rizzo being so far off the bag, I think confuses Russell here. Russell's looking to turn two. We see a different view right here. See how far off the bag Rizzo is. Now he goes to second. Russell, for a moment, if Gonzalez keeps running, he might get to third, because I think Russell was confused.
Totally.
Baez yelling at Russell to throw to third once Gonzalez stopped. Completed the double play.
Jorge Soler is batting for Carl Edwards, and what a job he did. As Joe Maddon pulls the right string with that first call out of the bullpen. We were talking with Mike Port, who is in our booth for any rules issues. Dave Roberts went out to at least converse after that play that ended the top of this sixth inning. And you have to believe infield fly was part of the conversation. That ball was not hit high enough for the umpires to call for the infield fly rule. Here's a 2-1. 2-2.
The reason that rule is in play for the integrity of the runners, because you can get in a situation where you have, it's an easy double play. I mean, the runners have to assume on a fly ball that it's going to be caught, so therefore that's why the infield fly rule, that just didn't quantify as a pop up.
2-2. Soler strikes out. Number 5 on the night for Kershaw in total command.
So here you see a little soft liner. He's yelling to get back. And now watch Russell. He thinks that's it, and then gets yelled at to throw to third. Once they throw to third, easy completion of the double play ball. Baez has been taught the game and knows the game and is never, I don't think, caught off guard by anything.
Here's Dexter Fowler back to the top of the order. Only 2 hits tonight for the Cubs.
Ball one. I used to say, as a pitcher, when there'd be a runner on first and the bunt was popped up right to you, take your time, let it drop, and turn two. I waited my whole career for that play. I told him it's going to happen. It did happen. I let it bounce. I turned and threw it in the center field. Both runners were set. The intent was there. The execution was not.
But Baez handled his chance a little better.
Much better.
There's so much more on Baez. We'll have time to cover it, you would think, before we go too much deeper into this LCS. Fowler's jammed on 2-0. 2-1.
And what makes that play work is because he was so deep. Had he been at regular depth, that ball's he's going to catch it in the air. He was so deep that he was able to stay back and short hop it and make it an impossible read for either runner once the ball was hit.
Fowler on 2-1. 2-2. Last thing for now, Baez told us yesterday he's naturally left-handed. So he eats left-handed. He writes left-handed. That's his glove hand. And Baez uses that dominant hand, has that great hand-eye coordination. It's a thing of beauty to watch him play. Fowler is jammed. Gonzalez won't get there.
Well, that's also why he's so good at tag. You know, his ability to slap down the tag. But look at where he is. He's at the edge of the infield, almost in the grass. And when this ball is hit, you see he just gets to a position where he can stay back. He knows exactly what he's going to do, and then it's up to Russell to figure out the rest.
With one out, nobody on, the count's 2-2 on Dexter Fowler. He homered last night before this crowd had a chance to settle back into their seats after a Wrigley Field shaking pinch hit grand slam by Miguel Montero unlocked a 3-3 tie.
Well, in a perfect scenario, I can't speak for every starting pitcher, but you'd want this scenario, 1-0 in the sixth, having a lead. They say, oh, pitch every game like it's 0-0. Well, it doesn't work like that. But having a lead, and then if your team can add in the seventh inning, what a huge boost of freedom that gives Clayton Kershaw from that point on.
2-2. First time Kershaw's been to three balls in the count all night.
See, that's what he does. He goes 3-2 fastball in, and the only thing the hitter could do is pull it foul. Now he can go 3-2 slider in the same spot and get Fowler, who wants to swing, aggressive, swing over the top of it or ground it to the shortstop or third baseman.
Fastball in. Popped up. Foul ball. Rondon. Two out. Dodgers are riding their horse here tonight, trying to even this best of seven. Our Michelob Ultra game summary. The only run of the night, a solo shot by Adrian Gonzalez back in the second. Kershaw didn't give up a base runner until there were two out in the fifth. That ties the Dodgers postseason record. Koufax in 63, World Series game one. Kyle Hendricks, a solid start, exactly what they needed. As Chris Bryant digs in, the offense for Chicago has been shut down again.
Early on, you talked about him not giving up hits. He executed his game plan, Kershaw, perfectly. Started Bryant off in, pitched him in, get him out of way now. Recently added that little drop down as another element to his fastball. Beauty of games like this as a starter, you wake up in the morning, you get prepared for this game to make 115 decisions. And those decisions matter when you're trying to get through a lineup for the third time, which rarely happens in this style of baseball that we're playing today.
Kershaw just caught that ball that he got back from Grandal barehanded. You think he's not locked in, fired up?
He was upset about that breaking ball. Haven't seen a ton of them.
Boy, he's fun to watch. 2-1. Fooled Bryant, 2-2. The pitch count is terrific. 69 pitches for Kershaw. One strike away from getting through six. He struck out 11 on Tuesday in game four of the division series, but threw 110 pitches to do it. Full count again.
Really grinding on that 2-2 slider, pulled it in the ground. With Rizzo on deck, there is no way Kershaw will just cave in and throw a strike for the sake of throwing a strike.
Bryant hit 39 home runs during the regular season. Stays alive.
There's a 3-2 slider. No, it wasn't in a perfect location. You got to protect against the fastball. See the late break. And Bryant fought it off.
Turner. Right at him. Inning over. And a guy who missed 2 months with a herniated disc in his back. He's got his team on his back right now, leading 1-0 after six.
ALCS on FS1. Tonight's telecast is presented by T-Mobile One. Mike Montgomery is the new pitcher for the Cubs. They got him from Seattle in season. He has elevated himself to a prime spot in the bullpen for Joe Maddon. He's been a starter, been a reliever. Who knows? Maybe he goes back to the rotation as the years go forward. But right now, working in the seventh in a 1-0 game. As Manny Grandal, the switch hitting catcher, up on the count here, 2-0. Pedro Strop is up for the Cubs in their bullpen.
The numbers significantly different, turning Grandal around. Only four home runs from the right side.
Three balls and a strike.
To your point, I think Montgomery becomes a really quality left-handed starter in the future. Right now, serving a great role out of Joe Maddon's bullpen.
That's ball four and a leadoff walk to begin the seventh. Second time Grandal's walked in this game. T-Mobile in-game box score for the Dodgers. Not many hits, just three of them. There have been five walks handed out. The only RBI on the home run by Gonzalez in the second. Kike Hernandez will come off the bench and bat for Andrew Tolles.
I wouldn't think there's any chance at all for a bunt in this situation with Kershaw on deck.
Montgomery walks the first man he faces, and now Hernandez, that's not hit hard.
Run.
Only play is to first for out number one. Down to second, Grandal. And here comes Kershaw, who has a hit. But he is fantastic in the other category. How he makes his money. He's pitched six shutout innings, allowing just two singles. Wait a minute now. Pitchers most times reaching base in National League postseason history.
That's got to be a misprint.
Our guy Smoltz. Your guy Glavin.
You know, chicks dig the long ball. Glavin and Maddox.
I still sense bitterness, and you weren't a part of that.
You are correct, sir.
0-1 on Kershaw. Big run sitting out there for the Dodgers. Breaking ball has Kershaw frozen. Strike two.
That's the go-to pitch for Montgomery. He's got a live fastball. Sometimes commanding it can be an issue, but man, he has tremendous break on that breaking ball. Tough on left-handers.
Strikes out. Two out. Now the left-handed hitting Chase Utley coming up. Kershaw in the bottom of this inning will face the big bats Rizzo, Zobrist, and Russell. 3, 4, and 5 hitters. Oddly would have been just fine if that ball hit him. Yeah. It missed him, ball one.
Yeah, the old saying, he's got ice. We got ice. Any way to get on base, but Utley has struggled against left-handers. Although curveballs, he can stay in there, and one that rolls over the plate. That's not what Montgomery wants to do. You got to stay firm with the fastball, maybe even that cutter.
Utley's hit 160
this year against left-handed pitching. And if you're the Cubs and if you're Mike Montgomery, this is the guy you got to get, even with all the postseason experience with the left-handed swinging Corey Seager on deck.
Yeah, absolutely. And with the air being a little bit tight for the Cubs because Kershaw's on the other side of that, each one of these pitches has so much more importance. You feel like you have a fighting chance in any game that's 1-0. You feel like you have a chance, but when Kershaw's on the other side, it's like less of a fighting chance, even though it's only one run.
Two and oh the count on Utley. Rondahl at second, two out. 3-0. A walk, a ground out, a strikeout. And Utley is looking for his pitch. Up on the count, 3-0. Ball four. And Seager will bat.
Well, some of these were close, and that one was just outside. And so now the cat and mouse game. Seager watched four balls go to Utley. I think Chris Bosio, this is a great time for the pitching coach to come out and reset the focus from Montgomery.
Seager coming up. It's also a great time to remind you tonight's telecast is sponsored by Dell and by AT&T, mobilizing your world. Almost 70 degrees at the start of the night here on the 16th of October. There's our set pregame, postgame. Some of the guys are there. Some of the guys are inside. Kevin Burkhardt. A-Rod. There's Bardia to the right. Clinton back to the left. Clinton in charge of keeping everybody safe, because I'm telling you, that is a madhouse out there after the game.
I think that conversation says trust your curveball. Something off speed, first pitch maybe.
Seager, strike one.
And he went with the cutter. So the fastballs were missing. The 90 mile an hour cutter, a good choice, as Corey Seager was going to be real aggressive after a walk of four pitches. See the late break. Good pitch.
Well, Montgomery's aware of the 2-for-3 for Corey Seager, who is 0-for-2 tonight. But hit 308 in his first full year in the big leagues, 26 home runs, 72 RBI. Two on, two out. 2-1 the count. Turner on deck and Stroke in the bullpen.
That's the right approach. I mean, lefty on lefty here. He struggles with the breaking ball and the slider, does Seager off of left-handers. He's got a hit with it.
That had a wrinkle to it in the count, 2-2.
So now with two strikes, the action pitch. Contreras is going to go out and make sure they're on the same plan here. Now you break out your best breaking ball. Whatever you have the most confidence in, whether it's that cutter he got strike one with, or the big breaking ball that Seager just fouled off right there.
In the air to left, Zobrist grabs it. And a scoreless frame put up by Mike Montgomery. Still 1-0, time to stretch. man in the middle of all the action, Clayton Kershaw, and there hasn't been much action around him when he's been on the mound. 72 pitches, two singles, that's it. He came back to back with two outs. Here's Rizzo, that was in the fifth. And Rizzo's now 0 for 7 in this series, 1 for 22 this postseason. Drove one deep but foul his last time up.
Well, the only blemish for Kershaw so far in the postseason, you could thank the St. Louis Cardinals, because from the seventh inning on, you're not going to believe the ERA. Innings 1 through 6, pretty good, 3.06. The seventh inning on, can you believe that? And that, really, the Cardinals. In his last start at home against the Nationals, he left with the bases loaded, two outs. Unfortunately, all those runs scored. That goes credited to Kershaw.
3-0 as action starts for the Dodgers in their pen. Kike Hernandez stays in the game and left. And Kenley Jansen, the closer, is up. We're in the seventh. First walk of the night handed out by Kershaw. They'll bring in Zobrist, who's had a couple of good swings tonight. But would Dave Roberts go to this well again? He brought on Kenley Jansen as closer in the seventh inning of game 5 in Washington, and it worked out as Kershaw got the final two outs. But Kenley restored order for the Dodgers through a career high 51 pitches. That was just on Thursday as we play here on Sunday night.
Yeah, those days off, I'm sure, did help Jansen.
Zobrist tying run on. Seventh inning. Popped him up back behind the plate. Gonzalez, Grandal didn't see it, and he can't make the play. Grandal's first move was toward the pitcher's mound, and he had to try to recover and couldn't get set up to make the catch.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, you saw the reaction to Kershaw. You try your best to block that out, but this is an out, and you make the pitch, and you know it's going to be an out, and here comes Gonzalez the whole way, and now a reprieve. A situation like this happened. I'm reminded of the David Price and Kansas City Royals in the World Series.
That's strike two.
You got to somehow block it out. Easier said than done when you've been invested mentally so much as Kershaw has in this inning.
Goes down as an error. The circuitous route that Yasmani Grandal took to it. Still got there, but couldn't make the catch.
I think Gonzalez getting right next to him could have caused a little confusion, or maybe just take your eye off the ball for a second.
0-2 on Zobrist. Got him looking as Kershaw bounces back. Not just from the leadoff walk, but from the error from Grandal.
Yeah, that is absolutely right. And a great pitch by Kershaw to take that away from the focus of what could have been pain on the outside part. This is the part we talked about earlier in the game. This is where Kershaw is going to have to grind more than he's ever grinded, because 1-0 in the seventh, he pretty much knows that if he can get through this inning, it's Kenley Jansen's opportunity to lock this thing down.
Here's Addison Russell. Struggling. Strike one. Still good velocity, mid 90s from Kershaw. 1 for 21. Addison Russell in this postseason. Two big arms on this Dodger staff. Second pitch this inning that's bounced in there from Kershaw. One ball, one strike.
this game so important for the Dodgers, just from the mental teeter-totter of what a series can be. Going back home, 1-1, knowing you got the middle three games, so much different than 2-0.
That's not hard hit. Kike Hernandez, two out.
It may go to Jansen right here against Baez. Baez has such an electric at bat. I think that is going to be it.
And Kershaw's not happy about it. If that is the case, Roberts has not made the call to the bullpen yet.
Usually when a manager claps his hands right there, it can be a precursor to what's to come. Maybe Kershaw can talk him out of it. And he liked what he had to hear.
Yeah, that was all Kershaw. And I like it. Dave Roberts said, it's up to you. And Kershaw said, let me have it. Javier Baez, who has one of the two Cub hits, has made another heads up good defensive play in this game.
Wow. Wow, Kershaw, you can see how much energy he's pouring into each pitch. That pitch right there had a lot of energy and reaction. Looked like it caught the corner. You can see Kershaw right here wanting it, rightfully so.
Baez into center. Back on the track, Peterson. And what a job by Clayton Kershaw tonight. Able to exhale after pitching around a leadoff walk. Baez brought this crowd to its feet with that shot to center. But the out sends us to inning number 8 in a 1-0 game.
available one in-game box score for the Cubs. That left column, all zeros except one hit for Baez, one hit for Contreras, and that's all. All Kershaw. 1-0. Eighth inning. Great game. Game two of the NLCS. Strope. Turner. A rolling breaking ball for strike one. It'll be Turner, Gonzalez, and Reddick. Not convinced that Clayton Kershaw's out of this game, are you?
I am.
You are. You think he's finished?
Channel a lot of energy. 1-0 game in and of itself. He's shocked. But I've been shocked before.
Here's a 1-1 to Turner, strike two. It's Rick Honeycutt, his pitching coach, saw his reaction at the end of the seventh inning when that ball was tracked down by Jock Peterson in center. Relief. Jansen's getting ready still in the bullpen. At least he's up.
The game speaks for itself and he speaks for himself, but I can't remember too many mistakes he made. He was able to keep the corners on the corners and keep the Cubs guessing. He doesn't walk anybody. He attacks with his fastball.
That is foul.
Strope better get a handle on his slider, which has absolutely not turned the corner against Turner.
Fourth pitcher of the night for Joe Maddon and the Cubs. Hendricks went 5 1/3. Good start. 1 run, 3 hits. Did walk 4, struck out 5. Now the home run to Gonzalez. Quick pitch, fouled back. Edwards came in, got a double play in the sixth. Montgomery walked 2. Pitched a scoreless seventh inning, and now here in the eighth, it's Strope.
I know Strope does this from time to time, but you better be pretty sure you're not using deception to have a mediocre pitch. You better grind on the best pitch you can make with 2 strikes.
Contreras wants it down in the dirt. Another foul.
Let it go.
One more that rolls over the middle of the zone, and Turner has got it timed. Could make this game 2-0.
Came back from knee surgery during the offseason, had a rough April. But a big part of the reason why the Dodgers turned it on the second half of the season. That was 55.5 feet.
Yeah, I mean, I watched him warm up, and you've seen the pitches he's thrown, and just the feel. Sometimes you come into a game, and we expect every reliever to have their best stuff every single time. That's the difference between a reliever and a starter who can develop his secondary touches and pitches as the game goes on. Not a reliever. He's got to have it. He has it or he doesn't.
Oh, that hit him. Turner, and that landed with a thud. Hit batsman to start this eighth inning. Well, got him on that protective guard he has in the left elbow. Here's a last out seven.
Well, you're hoping it's the right part of the ballpark. You see the number of your outfielder, the back of his number, and you're exhaling right about now.
Here's Gonzalez, double play ball. Out at second, Baez turns it 2 down. It is like an art form watching Baez fly across the bag for the double play.
Well, what's so impressive about this, they got the shift on. Watch how far he's got to come. This is way back at second base, and he's coming across the bag. And, of course, no big deal. Recognizes who's running. He's got plenty of time. By the way, nervous laugh, by the way.
Roberts?
You can imagine.
Maniacal.
You can imagine the.
Well, there's no doubt. I mean, think about it. As Reddick has the count even at a ball and a strike, Kershaw talked him out of the pitching change, and it worked.
Yeah.
Here's a 1-1. Redding takes ball two. Josh tonight 1-for-3. That was against the starter Hendricks, and his base hit in the sixth inning was the end of the night for Kyle. 2-1. Back to stroke. And after that hit by pitch to start the inning, stroke faces only three. Bottom of the eighth, bottom of the order coming up. Still 1-0 Dodgers. Brought to you by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you've got to get DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. Closer in the game in the eighth inning, Kenley Jansen. 1-0 Dodgers. Only a run, the home run by Adrian Gonzalez. Wilson Contreras leads it off, tries to bunt, and fouls it back. Strike one. Contreras, Hayward. And then the pitcher spot, Aroldis Chapman is getting ready for the Cubs in their bullpen, and Yasiel Puig has taken over in right. He'll bat ninth for the Dodgers, and the pitcher's now batting in the fifth spot where Reddick was. Has not allowed a run in 10 career games at Wrigley. Kenley Jansen 5-for-5 and save chances. He'll have to earn this one.
Well, and that's where he earns his money up. You'll see some, from time to time the Dodgers catchers will actually give that high target, because that cutter, that four seam cutter, so difficult for a hitter to get on top. The illusion is just the ball explodes to home plate.
The free agent to be, Kenley Jansen, brings home an 0-2. Struck him out, and a good start to the eighth inning.
High target, good results.
The night for Clayton Kershaw, absolutely fantastic. 7 innings, no runs, 2 hits, Back-to-back two-out singles in the fifth. That's it.
Sense to switch those two guys and put him.
One walk, six strikeouts. Here's Hayward. Strike one over the inside corner. It was Hayward who was up against Kershaw in the fifth. With two on and two out, the only Dodger scoring chance really tonight. And he fouled out the third.
Now if he elevates these balls against Hayward. Talked about the fastball velocity. Giving him troubles. Here's the flip side of if you can get a runner on base. You can steal on Jansen. Takes a long time to deliver the ball to home plate, but you got to get on base.
What a job he did on Thursday night in game five, taking over in the seventh. With a tying run on. That is hit off the end of the bat into right. Puig just into the game. Two out. Hayward 0 for 3. Tonight's telecast is sponsored by Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live Moss. And by Chevrolet, more 2016 JD Power Dependability Awards than any other brand. Last night's hero, Miguel Montero, comes off the bench to hit for stroke. And delivered the third pinch hit grand slam in postseason history. Ricky Lede, the last to do it. 99. That slam last night has only hit this postseason 1 for 5. Strike one. A slider from Blanton that Montero planted into the bleachers in right last night to make Wrigley Field shake. Trying to pump one out there and he came up empty.
That's a fresh arm right now after 52 pitches. Really nothing that you need to put down for the catcher other than keep raising the target.
Jansen, a former minor league catcher. At one point, the minors even caught Clayton Kershaw. Well, now he's trying to finish what Clayton Kershaw started tonight. Chapman will pitch in the top of the ninth.
What the day off obviously allows Dave Roberts the luxury of pitching in two innings.
Here's Kenley Jansen as a catcher. Think he had a good arm? Wow. From his knees a la Tony Pena. But the Dodgers turned him into a pitcher, and what a pitcher he's become. Catching there for Team Netherlands in the 09 World Baseball Classic. Here's the 0-2. A strikeout and an exclamation point at the end of the eighth inning for number 74. And the Dodgers are 3 defensive outs away from splitting the first 2 games here at Wrigley. Ninth inning, 1-0 Dodgers.
Ninth inning, Aroldis Chapman into the game. He's been involved in every postseason game this season for the Cubs. That means six. Four-game division series with the Giants. He's been in each of the first two games of this NLCS. He did allow two inherited runners to score last night, but was good enough to keep that game tied. According to Joe Maddon, anybody else, he believes the Cubs go into the bottom of the eighth inning trailing and may lose that game. But Chapman gave up the two-run single with two out to Adrian Gonzalez. Got Grandal on a ground out, kept it 3-3, and that is eating up a left-handed batter, 2-1.
We haven't seen many sliders out of him this postseason, so the first two Peterson were sliders there, a 99 mile an hour fastball. And you're right, Joe, I think the biggest thing again for closers and their mindset is they're always taught to get out of the jam. But if you keep the team in the game, and that means even if it's tied, that's exactly what Joe Maddon was talking about after the two strikeouts, the single, and then he gets out.
That is over but low, and Chapman stares in at the home plate umpires. The count's gone to 3-1.
We have some chirping out of the Cubs dugout, I'm sure.
Jock Peterson, 0-3, takes a walk. Travel day for this series tomorrow. Game three of the ALCS is on TBS tomorrow at 8 Eastern. The Indians and the Blue Jays with Cleveland up 2-0. And then at 4 Eastern on Tuesday, it's game four of that series, followed by game three of this one. Jake Arrieta, Rich Hill on FS1 at 7:30 Eastern out in LA. Watch it all live. Three on Fox Sports Go, if you wish. That's a check on the runner Peterson. Here's Grandal. He's walked twice. Just 2-for-19 this postseason. Runner goes. Throw down by Contreras is late. As was Addison Russell getting to the bag. Ball and player and runner arrived at the same time.
Well, something a lot of teams don't do is take advantage of closers who can't hold runners on. And you watch the closing speed, but it looks like Peterson got the initial look was looks like he got his foot in there before the tag, and that's exactly what you'll see. Keep the tag on, see if he lifts any separation on top of the bag. He does not. Big stolen base.
Peterson picked it up, had six during the regular season. Now Grandal waits. One ball, one strike. As he tried to bunt the runner over to third.
You gotta have soft hands. It's hard to hit off of Chapman, and it's hard to bunt. Ball's coming in there at such a velocity that you don't have soft hands and really let the barrel of the bat and the angle of the bat dent the ball. Recoil off that bat.
It's a perfect bunt. Bryant makes the play, and over to third is Peterson with only one out.
Great job. He had the angle of this bat perfectly to get it to third base. You must make the third baseman field the bunt, which allows the runner from second to easily go to third. Quiet, doesn't jab at it. And sets the barrel right in the perfect place. That's how you get it done.
So now the infield will come in.
Yes.
As Kike Hernandez digs his way in 0-for-1 tonight. Took over in this spot for Andrew Toles. Added to the active roster for this LCS. He's not on the roster for the division series.
Ball one with a huge run sitting 90 feet away.
Now if the count goes in the favor of the Dodgers, you could also watch for a safety squeeze. You see Rizzo is going to be in. Bryant's going to be in. Idea off of Chapman to get one elevated to try and get a fly ball, easier said than done. Big swings don't get it done against a guy that throws this hard.
Adrian Gonzalez, who got the big hit last night off Chapman, said the key for him, I would imagine this applies to right-handed hitter, left-handed hitter, doesn't matter, is to quiet the legs when a guy's throwing that hard. You quiet the legs, you trust your hands, trust your eye, and you try to make contact. That's into shallow center. Who wants it? Fowler. Here's the throw. Home runner stops, two out. Peterson holds up wisely. Hayward wanted it, but Fowler stayed with it and made the catch.
Yeah, there was that little doubt that Hayward, with a great arm, but being left-handed, Fowler can come straight in once he catches it. And he decided that that was the place to be. See Hayward trying to get it, and then Fowler at the last minute saying, no, 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 no.
Well, now if the lead is going to be doubled, it's up to Yasiel Puig, who is one for his last 25 in the postseason.
Yesterday, Gonzalez talking to Puig on how to handle a guy like Chapman. Soft hands.
Runner at third, two out. Strike one. Dodgers will have Kenley Jansen on the mound in the bottom of this inning, and for the Cubs, the top of the order, Fowler, Bryant, Rizzo. Chapman trying to keep it a one-run game. And Peterson came way down the line, hoping maybe for a balk.
That's a good idea. Bryant was way off the bag. Sometimes you might get that little movement. But Chapman composed.
Worth a try.
Absolutely.
Here's a bunt in the air. Chapman has it. And gets around the leadoff walk in the stolen base. Yes, pitchers are allowed to catch pop-ups.
Amen.
And the top of the order coming up for the Cubs. What a game. Game two. Cubs leading one game to nothing, trailing tonight 1-0. decision over the offseason when they let Zach Greinke go to the Arizona Diamondbacks. This has been the time this postseason where the Cubs done the majority of their damage, at least with their average, the home runs, the last two innings, plus they've come up with 12 of their 25 runs. But when the Dodgers made that choice, John, they let Greinke go for over $200 million to the divisional rival Arizona. The Diamondbacks got it. They knew going into this season that they would have to ride Clayton Kershaw and win a high percentage of his starts. Here's Fowler. Ball one. If the Dodgers win tonight, combining the regular season and the postseason, they will have won 20 of his 24 starts and throw in a save for good measure in game five of the division series. That is making the most of the best pitcher in baseball. The 1-0 to Fowler. Strike one.
Well, the Dodgers are also trying to avenge a 1-0 loss to the Cardinals in 2013. That's the last 1-0 game in an NLCS.
A 1-1 to Fowler. Strike two.
Jansen also trying to record his first six out save. So a lot of things on tap here in the heart of the order. And again, if somebody gets on, the stolen base is there for the Chicago Cubs.
Well, this is obviously the guy they like to be on base, Dexter Fowler. He can run. 1-2 pitch. Struck him out. One away. Strikeout number three for Jansen. And now the two biggest home run threats in the lineup for the Cubs are coming up.
Well, he has been able to beat everybody with that cutter. Doesn't matter where the pitch is. This is the at bat, and this is the player who can handle that pitch, especially belt high.
Ryan 0 for 3 tonight. One home run this postseason.
No.
Late strike call. To the dismay of Chris Bryant.
That's an unhittable pitch. You watch this front door cutter, but it never comes close to the strike zone. So now what that does to Bryant, it affects the pitch selection he attempts to go after, trusting that those are not going to be called the same way.
Rondon wants it up. Strike two.
Everybody at home might be saying, well, it's just one pitch. Well, not to a hitter who knows that 94 to 97 miles an hour already is difficult to hit. Pitch right there changes the mindset of Bryant. That's ball one. Instead, strike one, then to 0-2, and he just paints at 96.
Well, here you go, Anthony Rizzo. 0-for-2 tonight, 1-for-22 this postseason. About 32 home runs during the regular year. Last chance for Chicago. Broken bat should end it. It does. Dodgers win 1-0, and they've split the first two games of this NLCS in Chicago. And let's say this, John, anybody who counted out the Dodgers when they were 8 back of the good San Francisco Giants ball club and they lost Clayton Kershaw with a herniated disc for 2 months, and this Dodger team did not quit. They ended up winning the division by 4 games. They fell down early last night. They didn't quit. They tied the game in the 8th. They lost it. But tonight, behind Clayton Kershaw and Kenley Jansen and a home run from Adrian Gonzalez, They win 1-0, and the last time the Cubs were shut out at home in the postseason, the winner was Babe Ruth, the Boston Red Sox.
Well, there's no such thing really as a good loss in the postseason, but don't tell the Dodgers that. They thought yesterday's game was, in essence, a good loss. They had a lot of energy from the game. They battled, they came back, and they felt great coming into this start by Clayton Kershaw, and the fact that they could get 7 innings. Remember, we said in the beginning, if Clayton could give them 7, Jansen was going to close it out, and he did.
1 run on 3 hits for the Dodgers, and that was enough. Let's go down to Tom Verducci.
Kenley Jansen, you never had a 6-out save before in your career. Welcome to October. How did it feel?
Man, it's all fun. You know, there's the 2 best teams playing right now. You know, we're facing the best team in the National League. You know, you just got to feed off it, you know. Whenever you face best hitters like that, great hitter like that, you just want to go out there and compete, especially, you know, Kersh, what Kersh did in game 5, and, you know, come out here and carry this team on his back is just give you a little bit more energy to go out there and you know, take over and try to get that win.
Kenley, what did you think of the way that Kershaw pitched tonight? You've been teammates with him since you were teenagers in the Gulf Coast League. The effort, the way he pitched tonight.
Man, that's awesome. Watching Kersh, that kind of show you he's the best in the game. I mean, you know, his stuff that he had, the way how he pitched against this team, you know, that's great. He showed you again. He can just put this team on his back and carry on and try to get that victory.
Kenley, congratulations. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Joe, back to you.
Tom, thank you. The difference in the game, one swing of the bat, there were a total of 5 hits in this game between these two teams. But here's the biggest one. Out of the park into left center off the bat of Adrian Gonzalez. And he's standing by with Kenny Rosenthal.
Thanks, Joe. Adrian, you told us before the game that you wanted to get Kershaw runs early. You thought it was really important. You got a pitch to hit in the second inning. What was your thought process going into that at bat?
No, I mean, just try to elevate, you know, try to get the ball in the air. And he's a sinker ball guy. He wants to keep the ball down. But, you know, for the most part, I just wanted to hit something in the air. And thank God, you know, I was able to get a pitch and elevate it.
You've seen Kershaw throw a lot of great games. How would you describe tonight?
He was incredible. He was the Kershaw we know, the Kershaw we unfortunately we come to expect, and he was incredible. I mean, you know, throwing 7 shut there and then letting Kenley do the rest of the work. You know, that's what we needed out of him, and he provided everything we needed.
Kenley, 51 pitches Thursday night, 2 innings tonight. How impressed were you by what he did?
Oh, I mean, you know, he's our workhorse in the back end there, and when we can get him the ball, we feel really confident about our chances to win. And he proved today again why.
How do you like your chances going back to L.A.?
I mean, you know, we like our chances a lot. We like where we're at right now.
Adrian, thank you. Joe, back to you.
Yes, this is a series, no doubt. These Dodgers will not fold. They proved that in the regular season. They proved that against the Nationals. And here they are getting out of Chicago with a series tied at a game apiece. Kenny Rosenthal's not finished working. He's going underneath to visit with Clayton Kershaw. And you will see that interview on the postgame show. One more time, the Dodgers have won 20 of Clayton Kershaw's combined 24 starts. He was brilliant tonight. Kevin, guys, all yours.